इज इट विजिबल स्क्रीन?
यस सर,
यस्टरडेज क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट ग्रीडी स्ट्रेटेजी टू डेवलप द एल्गोरिथम्स. सो इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड वन ऑफ द मिनिमल स्पैनिंग ट्री टेक्निक. ओके, दिस पोर्शन वी आर डिस्कसिंग ना हाउ टू स्टोर द ग्राफ्स, एडजेसेंसी मैट्रिक्स. दिस पार्ट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, इजंट इट? ओके, एडजेसेंसी लिस्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन एंड मिनिमम स्पैनिंग ट्री. ओके, नाउ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द मिनिमम स्पैनिंग ट्री, ए कनेक्टेड टू टाइप्स ऑफ ग्राफ्स, कनेक्टेड ग्राफ, डायरेक्टेड ग्राफ, अनडायरेक्टेड ग्राफ. And each edge is associated with a function e is goes to r. So means all the edges have a different weights. Okay. Now what is a minimal spanning tree? For example, this is a tree, a graph. So what is the minimal spanning tree? This is a minimal spanning tree. Now I want to give a simple assignment. For example, this is a graph. You consider this is a graph, and this is the minimal spanning tree given. Okay, this different color edges. Now, can you draw another minimal spanning tree other than this? Just simple assignment. In 1 minute, you can do it. I think. Just this is a graph. You draw one more minimal spanning tree. Anyone? It's not required to minimum. Just you find a minimal spanning tree and you show it. Are you following my question? Are you understand my question?
Yes.
Yeah, for this graph, just you can draw another minimal spanning tree. Anyone? Yeah, start. I hope you are doing. Anybody is completed? Anyone over? Anybody completed? For this graph, one more minimal spanning tree. Over, anybody? Over. No need to calculate the sum of the minimal span weights. Just you can draw another minimal spanning tree other than this. Okay. Have you done or not? Why you are taking this much time? It's very simple. Is it over? Abhishek Seal, Navchandra, Sankalp. Gaurav, What's the problem? You tell me. Somebody is trying to show. Who's he or she? Abhishek Seal. Pura dikhao usme nahi dikha rahe. ये कितने कितने वर्टेसेस 1 2 3 4 5 6 ओके गुड गुड उसका वेट्स भी लगाओ वेट्स लगाओ वेट्स लगाओ यू कैन ऐड द वेट्स दैट एडजेस मस्ट बी देयर मस्ट बी इन दैट ग्राफ द ऑल द एडजेस व्हिच यू हैव कनेक्टेड शुड बी एग्जिस्ट इन द ग्राफ देन ओनली दैट विल बिकम ए मिनिमल स्पैनिंग ट्री ओके नाउ यू ऐड द वेट्स ऐड द वेट्स next anybody Is it visible? My screen is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now you see this is one minimal spanning tree, na? Okay. Now I can take one more. For example, you can take like this: 12, you can add. This 6, you can add. 14, you can add. 8, you can add. This 10, you can add. So all the edges, all the vertices you can add with one edge, any one edge, then it will become a spanning tree. Why you are taking this much time? I'm not getting. See, what is there here? This 12 is skipped, na? In this, you can add that 12. Then that will become another minimal spanning tree. This 12, you can add. 6, you can add. All the vertices should add. How many vertices are there in this? 8. Okay. Then the spanning tree should add 8 vertices, any one of the edge. So that you should not add this 6, 5, 12, because this will form a cycle. Okay. Minimal spanning tree should not have a cycle. Getting? Now, how many spanning trees you can form? There are various spanning trees you can form. Each spanning tree is having its edge, its weight. Okay. But what is the problem here? We have to find the minimal spanning tree. Okay, so there are various spanning trees we can find, out of which we have to find the minimal spanning tree. For that, there are two algorithms are there: Prim's algorithm and Kruskal algorithm. Both of these algorithms are following greedy strategy, right? So what is greedy mechanism? Local optimal. Every time, whenever you are selecting a new node or edge, whatever it is. Okay, then you have to follow the local optimal procedure. That's it. Okay, then that is going to be a global optimal. Now, for that, there is a concept we are going to discuss now: optimal substructure. Okay, are you following now? Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. How to just
yes.
What we have discussed till now, there are two graphs are there: directed graph, undirected graph. You know what is the difference between directed graph and undirected graph. And after that, we have discussed, we have introduced a weight function for each and every edge. Now, weight function is defined from edge to real number. Okay, each edge is associated with a real number. So that real number could be depend on the application. For example, if you take two nodes as the places, Then the what is the distance between distance? The edge is distance. Suppose if you take two nodes or switches or routers in a network, then it can be a bandwidth. Okay. So suppose if you connect one server to another server, so then in between what is there? It is a bandwidth is there. So it is computer networks application. So whenever you are connecting the nodes, it depends on the application. What you are assuming as a node, and what is the parameter you want to define in between these two nodes. Okay, so that weight function we have assigned, right? Then minimal spanning tree total weight is, what is the minimal spanning tree total weight? Sum of all the edges. So this is one graph we have considered, and this is the spanning tree. And it's what is the total weight? 6 plus 5 plus 8 plus 3 plus 7 plus 9 plus 15. Like this, you can find various other spanning trees, and those spanning trees weights also we can find. But what is our ultimate goal? Ultimate goal is to find the minimal spanning tree. So for that, we have to follow some procedure, right? That procedure basically two types. One is Prim's algorithm, another one is Kruskal, right? These two principles now we are going to discuss. So before going to discuss these principles, we have to learn some concept, that is optimal substructure, right? Now this is actually minimal spanning tree. Okay, other edges of G are not shown here. So we have considered a graph G. And from that we have considered one optimal structure like this. This is a minimal spanning tree. Okay. Now, remove any edge UV belongs to T, right? Other edges of G are not shown here. You remove any edge from this tree, then what is going to be happen? From a tree, if you remove any edge, then that is going to be a disconnected. So this is a tree and this is another tree. See here, this is one T1 and this is another T2. If you want, you can note down. First, we are discussing a concept called optimal substructure. So this is one of the minimal spanning tree from a graph G. Okay, here we are not showing any graph. Okay, just we have considered one optimal substructure from the minimal spanning tree, right? Now in this, you can remove one edge, right? So once if you remove the edge, then it is going to be disconnected, right? These two. From any tree, if you remove an edge, that tree is going to be disconnected into two components, T1, T2. Okay. Now U belongs to T1 and V belongs to T2, right? Now remove any edge, then T is partitioned into two subtrees, T1 and T2, right? Now, theorem. The subtree T1 is an MST of G1 is equal to V1 comma E1. So this is a minimal spanning tree for graph G1. Okay. The subgraph of G induced by the vertices of T1. Actually, what is G1? G1 is a subgraph to G. Okay, and induced by the vertices. What are the vertices in T1? What are the vertices of G1 of T1, right? V1 is equal to vertices of T1, E1, edges, X comma Y belongs to E, X comma Y belongs to V1. Similarly for T2. Are you following this statement of the theorem?
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes.
You can note down. If you note down, then you can understand more clear. What we did now, just we have taken an optimal substructure, that is a minimal spanning tree, right? So from that, what we did, we have removed an edge. Okay, then it is divided into two trees, T1 comma T2. Actually, that tree where we have taken the optimal structure from a graph G. Okay, now now here the subtree T1 is a minimal spanning tree for graph G1. Subtree T2 is a minimal spanning tree for graph G2. Okay, now what is G1? V1 comma E1. What is V1? V1 is all the addresses from the T1. And what is E1? E1 is an, it is coming from an edge. And what is X comma Y? X comma Y belongs to V1 vertices. Similarly, V2 is vertices of T2. E2 is X comma Y belongs to E, such that X comma Y belongs to V2, right? Now, see here, weight of T, weight of total T, this one, tree, spanning tree, this one, before removing an edge. Okay, that is equal to U comma V weight, U comma V weight union plus W of T1 weight plus W of T2 weight. Is it true? Are you agreeing this? Are you agreeing this? Weight of capital T. Weight of capital T. So what is the weight of this capital T? Each and every edge weight, no? Each and every edge weight. So this is modified into how? Just we have removed this one. This is UV and this weight plus this one is T1 plus this one is T2. So that is partitioned into three parts. One is U comma V weight plus W of T1 weight plus W of T2. Okay. If T1 dash were a lower weight spanning tree than T1 for G1, then, okay, now you see here, T1 dash were a lower weight spanning tree than T1. Suppose if you have another T1 dash, okay, T1 dash, which is lower than T1, then what is the, then T1, T dash is equal to what? T dash is equal to UV union T1 dash union T2 would be a lower weight spanning tree than T for G. Similarly, you can also find here T2 dash also. Yeah, are you understand this one, this statement you have, this slide you have followed now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, do we also have a overlapping subproblems? Yes. So now, yes, but MST exhibit another powerful property which leads to an even more efficient algorithm. Okay. Now, a locally optimal choice is a globally optimal. Now, actually, here the problem is we have to find T1 dash. Okay. You have to find T1 dash. How do we find T1 dash? For that, we have to follow a principle that is called greedy algorithm. Okay. Let T be minimal spanning tree of G. Okay. V comma E. And let AE subset are equal to V. Suppose that U comma V belongs to E is the least weight edge connecting A to V minus A. Then U comma V belongs to T. This is a theorem. Let T be the minimal spanning tree of G, V comma E. And let AE subset are equal to V. Okay. A is another vertex set. Subset are equal to V. Suppose that U comma V belongs to E is the least weight edge connecting to A to V minus A. A to V minus A. Then UV belongs to T. What is capital A here? Are you understanding what is capital A? What is capital A? Anybody? What is this A and B minus A? Anybody? Are you following capital A and V? A, B minus A? What is A and B minus A?
I can't get it.
Huh? Now you see, let T be the minimal spanning tree of a graph G, V comma E, and let AE subset are equal to V. Suppose that UV belongs to E is the least weight edge connecting to A to V minus A. Then U comma V belongs to T. What is A and V here?
ये इज द वर्टेक्स देखो,
बी इज ऑल्सो वर्टेक्स है, टोटल वर्टेक्स यो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू टेक दिस ग्राफ यू कैन टेक या. सो दिस इज ए ग्राफ ना टोटल. सो दिस इज यू वी ना, आर यू यू से दिस इज यू वी ना, दिस एंटायर वर्टेक्स इज कैपिटल वी, ऑल दिस वर्टेक्स. वॉट इज कैपिटल ए, यो दिस वन, दिस इज कैपिटल ए. Is this is subset are equal to V? Yes, this is subset are equal to V. Are you following now? What is capital A and what is V minus A? Right. What is V minus A? This is V minus A. This portion is V minus A. This is UV. Now this is A, capital A. This is capital A, and this is V minus A. Total V. Now understood what is capital A and V?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is capital A. See here, this is UV edge. When this UV belongs to capital T, then this should be the minimum edge connecting from V to A minus V. There are several other edges also there, na? There are several other edges also there to connect V, U to V. You might be, this might be another edge. So there are several edges may be connected, but this UV, na? This UV, for example, you take here one more vertex here, one more vertex are from here, this you connect here, from here also. That is also connecting U to V from here like this, right? But this UV edge is the minimum weight. For example, this weight is 1000. This may be 50 or 60 or this is 40. So this might be the easy way, na, connect to U to V, okay? So here, when UV belongs to T, this should be the minimum weight, okay? To connecting from A to V minus A, right? Now I think you are following. Okay, now this statement I think clear now. Let T be the minimal spanning tree of graph G is equal to V comma E. Let A is subset R equal to V. Suppose that U comma V belongs to E is the least weight edge connecting A to V minus A, then UV belongs to E. Right now, this is the proof actually. Theorem. This is the theorem. Every theorem statement must be clear to you. Then proof is easy. Proof of the theorem. Suppose UV does not belongs to T. Let us assume that UV does not belongs to T. What is meant by that? UV does not belongs to T means there must be another edge connecting U to V. Okay, there must be another path. Okay, connecting U to V, that must be minimum, then only become a spanning tree. Okay, now you see here, this is T. See here, this color edges belongs to A. Okay, this is light violet color. Zero belongs to, this edge belongs to A. And this red color belongs to V minus A. All these red colors are there now. These are V minus A. V minus A. And these are A. Means to partition, we have partitioned into. Okay, now this is UV. This is UV. Least weight edge connecting A to V minus A. This is, okay, and for following now, this one, this path, right? Suppose if this is also included and this is also included, then it is not a minimal spanning tree, na? Because this is a cycle is going to be formed. Suppose if you add this one, anyone may, this might be removed, okay, this should be removed, then it is okay. Now okay, this path is going to be redundant. Suppose UV does not belongs to T, so consider the unique simple path from U to V in T. Okay, U to V in T. So swap U comma V with first edge on this path that connects a vertex in A to a vertex in V minus A. Okay, now you see, swap U comma V with the first edge on this path that connect a vertex in A to V minus A. Okay, so this swap, we have to swap this vertex. This edge, swap U comma V with the first edge, means this one, on this path. Are you following now? Now you remove this, you remove this, because this is UV is the least weight edge connecting A to V minus A. Okay, now UV is the least weight edge connecting A to B minus A. So this should be in T, not this one. So that's why you have to swap it, right? You have to swap this with this one. This is the optimality principle. Are you following now? Now, how to follow this optimality principle? By using Prim's algorithm. Okay, you have to follow the Prim's algorithm. Maintain V minus A as a priority queue. Key each vertex in queue with the weight of the least weight edge connecting. Okay, now you see, if you see by an example, then you can understand what is the optimality principle. See here, this is initially this vertex is included, because the algorithm starts from any one of the vertex. Okay, now this vertex is initially included, right? Now this is going to become violet. Now how many vertices are there in A? 0, 1. Now next, it is going to be add either this one or this one or this one. See here. Now which one is going to be add next vertex? Tell me. Optimality, according to optimality principle?
7.
7. Now this 7 is going to be added now to A. Now you tell me, next 7 is connected to this one. Which one is going to be connected next?
5.
5. Okay. Now this is going to be violet. 5 is going to be violet. And now 5, how many are there? These are there. Now which one is going to be selected next?
6.
6 is going to be violet. Next, like this, right? So this, you repeat the same thing. Are you following now? Okay, now these are the going to be edges is going to be added. Are you following now,
sir? Yes, sir. Can I start from vertex 8?
Yes, you can. You can start. You can start do that. You can start from 8 and you can find the minimal spanning tree. You can do it. Now that is an exercise for you. You can do it now. You can. Start doing. Not only 8. You can start from anywhere. You can start from anywhere and you find out the spanning tree. Have done anybody with any other vertex? You take it as a homework. If you want, you can do it now. This is the Prim's algorithm illustration. I hope you understand this algorithm. Now this is the Prim's algorithm. Maintain V minus A as a priority queue Q. Initially, what is A? Initially, what is A? Singleton element, anyone. Okay. V minus A as a priority queue Q. Key each vertex in Q with the weight of the least weight. Hello. Is it okay? The prims algorithm.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can just follow this algorithm. Then now we have to see the procedure. You have understood, I think. Just you take one vertex and from outgoing vertices, the least vertex we have to select. Okay. Now suppose.
So you have to cover all the vertices, right?
Yes, you have to try, you have to select all the vertices without any forming a loop. Suppose if you find another edge, then if it is forming a loop, that we have to remove it. All the vertices it should add. Okay.
Okay.
It's very simple algorithm. Simple. If you take one, two or three graphs, then it is easily you can understand. So what is the analysis now? This is v times. Okay, this should be v times, and this is also theta of v. And then the complexity. Okay, later on we can discuss this complexity. Now another algorithm is Prim's algorithm, Kruskal algorithm. Now you see here, this is the algorithm complexity is v square, and this is e log v. And this we can discuss later. Now another algorithm, Kruskal algorithm. Yeah, this is it visible, the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now you see another graph from this textbook. Okay. Now you see this graph. If you want, you can note down on your copy. You can note down on your copy this graph. Now with this graph, I can explain now both algorithms, Prim's and Kruskal. Have you taken this graph on your copy? Okay. Now the stages. You select this one. Okay. Then next, this one, because this one is 28. See here, this is 28. So we have to select this only. Okay. Now once if you select this one, then which one is the next minimum? See here, this one you have selected. How many are there? This is 24. This is 22. Now this one. Okay. Now from here again, this is 2 values. Like this. This is the stages of the Prim's algorithm. Now, if you follow this algorithm, now next Kruskal algorithm. This algorithm is Prim's. Just you can implement this algorithm. It's very easy. You can write the code for that. Now, Kruskal algorithm, just you can, all the edges are there, no? The edge weights, you can add it in increasing order. Okay, are you following now? All the edges you have to add in increasing order. First, you add the least weight, this one. This is 10 is the least. Then you can add the next least weight. Then you can add the next least weight. Then you can add next least weight. You can add the next least weight. Next least weight edge, like that. You keep on continue. Are you following now the procedure of Kruskal? What is the difference between Prim's and Kruskal? In Prim's algorithm, a vertex by vertex we are going to add, but whereas in a Kruskal algorithm, edge by edge we are going to add. So in the Kruskal algorithm, all the edges we are writing in a increasing order. Okay, the first edge we will take it, least edge, then the second least edge, like this. We are keep on adding. Suppose at any stage, if you add one edge, minimum wedge, if it is forming a loop, then you have to remove that and add the next one. That's it. Okay, because the spanning tree should not have cycles or cycle, no. So that's why you have to remove that edge. That's all.
Sir, why you don't connect 5 and 6?
Where? Here.
In this graph, we don't connect the 5 and 6. This.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. The last one, the F.
This one.
Last F. Yes, sir.
This, what is the weight? Edge weight of 5 to 6. 5 to 6 weight. How much?
25.
Yeah, 25 might be large. 5 to 6. If you add 25, that is going to be weight more, na?
So, but we have to connect all vertexes.
No, the next stage it is going to be add all. Next stage, it's not completed. This is not completed. Yep. This is not completed. No, this is not completed. One more is either this one. The next weight is how much? Next weight. This is 22, na? Next weight 25 only, na? So this is going to be added.
Yes,
now.
Sir.
This is going to be added. It's not complete here. This graph, this entire, if G is also there here, this is also connected. Okay.
Okay.
This is actually, it's not a minimal spanning tree, na? It's not a spanning tree actually. Then you have to connect either this one or this one. If you connect, how much this is 1 to 2? Is there any connectivity is there from 1 to 2 in the graph?
Yes, sir. 28.
28. Yeah, very. 1 to 2, 28. But this one?
Sir, 5 to 6, 25.
So this one is going to be added, not this one. But there is only two possibilities. No, either this is going to be connected or this is going to. So this one is the least. That's why this is going to be connected. Now you can do once you take a graph and try to find a minimal spanning tree by using Prim's algorithm, and try to find another spanning tree by using Kruskal algorithm, and you find the weights. Which one will be the giving the minimum? Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, you can follow. You can apply the two algorithms. Take any graph randomly with 5, 6 vertices, 10 vertices, a graph. Okay, and you find the minimal spanning tree by using Prim's algorithm. Minimal spanning tree by using Kruskal algorithm. And those two minimal spanning trees weights you have to find out.
Sir, if the minimum, then both edge are equal.
Where? Yeah, you can take any one. If both the edges are minimum, then you can take any one. You should take any one. Okay, that's why there is no optimal algorithm. Sometimes Kruskal will give better result, sometimes Prim's will give better result. It depends on the graphs sometimes. Okay. Now you try to write a programs for these two algorithms and analyze the time complexity. So once if you practice it, then analysis is easy. So this is the algorithm actually, Kruskal algorithm. See, t is equal to pi. Initially nothing is there, while t has less than n minus 1 edges, t has n minus less than n minus edges, and e is not equal to pi. Then you have to do choose an edge vw from E of lowest cost. Okay, delete V comma W from E. Okay, if E V comma W does not create a cycle in T, then add V comma W to T. Else discard. That's it. Simple procedure this is. Whatever we have discussed orally, it is putting in the form of an algorithmic statement. But in detail, this is the algorithm. Right? Okay. Now you have to write a program for this. It's very easy. Already it is available on the website also. If you want, you can try. You can get the code, C language code also. Just you give an input of graphs, adjacency matrix, then you will find the, you can get the minimal spanning tree. Right? Okay. I'd like to stop at this point. So today we have discussed Kruskal algorithm and Prim's algorithm.